Good afternoon. Welcome to our webinar. Webinar, what is offered on map content? To introduce myself, my name is Jaap Groen. I work for map content. And today I'm here with my colleague Charles Lex.
Hello, good afternoon. My name is Charles and I'm involved with sales for map content.
Yeah, thank you, Charles. I'm myself, I'm responsible for marketing map content. Beforehand in this webinar, if you have any questions, feel free to ask them. You can use the GoToWebinar panel, which is on the right side of your screen. You can type in your question. We try to answer this during the webinar, but we also host a Q&A session after the webinar. So if you have some deep questions, we're happy to go into these questions after the webinar. Well, what will you learn today in this webinar? The webinar is titled What is Offered on Map Content? So today we'd like to explain to you just what types of content are offered on map content, but more importantly, why do we offer this content and how is it generated? But first, we'd like to tell you a little bit more about map content.
Yeah, well, you see on the screen some figures, but to go in depth of map content, it's now already active for more than 17 years. And we publish on the map content website uniform Revit models. We found out that on a monthly basis, more than 28,000 engineers are visiting this website, and they get more than 500 articles, where there are 500,000 articles available from more than 290 manufacturers. As you can see here, the content is reached out globally, so on around the globe, everybody can download the content actually for free, and it's all been made by the EMCS content standard, and we will go in depth on the EMCS later on. Map content is hosted by Stabiplan, and Stabiplan is a company established 27 years ago, so we can say we do have 27 years of map experience with more than 170 employees. We are mainly working on platforms as Revit and AutoCAD, and we provide for this platform's software, well known as Stabicad software, and data for it. And we do have countries, in five countries offices, as in Germany, in France, Netherlands, Belgium, and in Romania. And as you can see, we also support more than 10,000 Stabicad users with our software.
Okay, thanks. So what are we all about? Well, you, as a map content user or manufacturer, this is the site you will see most often of map content, and is the most important part of our company. It's our actual BIM platform. Well, as you can see, this is the homepage, and you see we offer BIM content for MEP projects. Map content is the platform for major manufacturers in the MEP, from all around the world, actually. And the content we offer can be used both in Revit and AutoCAD. And if you didn't have a look yet, I would strongly encourage you to please have a look at our website and see it for yourself. Yeah, well, as it says here, content is everything. And of course, we're a content platform, so for us, content is everything. But what we see in the MEP industry is that, in the construction industry in general, is that the role of 3D content, digital content, is more and more important. Why is this? Well, content is used at the start of every construction project nowadays. And content is nowadays the basis for many projects. And if content used in a project is not correct, it will influence the quality, and it will influence the calculations made in projects. It will influence the eventual realization. So content is really important and more used for example, also prefab projects. We think it's very important to have high quality project content for engineers. And this is why we are cooperating with more than 290 manufacturers to offer MEP engineers content on our platform. We're really proud to have this base already of manufacturers, and what we see is that every month we have more and more manufacturers joining our platform. And we're working every day together with manufacturers to offer MEP engineers a better assortment of content, just so you can go to this platform and make sure you find high quality content. Speaking of this content, we're proud to host more than 500,000 products on our platform. And these 500,000 are divided over different file types, and what kind of file types these are, we will go into this later. But yeah, just to know, as an MEP engineer, you can go to our platform and discover the types of content yourself. And we're working every day on, well, guaranteeing we can offer you the assortment you need and also the quality. And speaking of quality, Charles, we have EMCS. What is it?
Yeah. Well, you said more than 500,000 products for the engineer. And what we can see here is that it's daily growing with new content and new requests from manufacturers. But if you have this kind of amount of content, you want to be sure that the quality is being guaranteed and that the data is attached to it is the right data. So the engineer knows what he's going to get, and he knows that the data, what has been provided on map content, is the right content. So what we have done, we said to ourselves, maybe it's a good idea to show the engineer and show the manufacturer what kind of content we are building, how we are building it, and what kind of standard has been reached. So we introduced the EMCS, the European Map Content Standard. And that's a standard that will help the engineer and will help the manufacturer to see how the content has been built, what kind of information is attached to it, and how it can be used in different kinds of projects. Because we see around the globe that every project have his own need, his own BIM protocols that has been reached to. So we found some goals in it, and we said, well, it's very good to know that the content is compact content. It's small, it's easy to use, it is fast in a large project, for example. We can guarantee that the data that's attached to it is the right and the high quality data. It is easy to maintain. That's a good thing to know for the manufacturers, because content is changing. Your product range is changing, so you need to change your content as well. Sometimes some products will be obsolete, no longer available in store. So the engineer couldn't choose that one, and he need to choose a new product. So that's what we do on maintenance as well. We provide it with deep links, so you can find more attached information to it. And it's uniform, so you know what kind of content you are going to get. If we talk about the European content standard, well, you can see here on the screen that are in several countries, there's already some kind of BIM standard established. If we look at the UK, for example, they have the COBE as a standard, they have the national BIM standard, and when you are a manufacturer, you need to reach those qualifications to get your content out there. Well, that's what we have done with the EMCS, and we see now that that document represents a vision of more than 290 manufacturers that already has adapted this standard to publish their content. So it's not just a standard, it's the standard for content around Europe, and actually globally it's been accepted more and more and more. But we will see later on in the presentation what the EMCS means and what kind of data has been attached to it. So we come to data to content. Jaap.
Yeah. Well, we offer high quality content. Just as you will understand, this will also take some work. And we have a large team working here in Bodegraven, but also in other parts of Europe on creating this content. Just I'd like to go into a bit deeper on how this content is created. This machine gives you a bit of an overview of exactly how this is done. And as you can see, it all starts with the PIM, the PIM, which is the Product Information Management System for manufacturers. And this is where they will store parts of their product data. And the data in this system is the source for all of our content. So manufacturers, they provide us with this data. And as you can see, we match it with all the standards Charles just also explained, such as ETIM, but also VDI, COBE, NLSFB, depending on the country where we're talking about. But we match the manufacturer data with these standards. And with that in mind, we match it also with the rest of the terms which are in the EMCS. And from there on, as you can see, we create different types of content with these ingredients. And these types are IFC, DVG, RFA, and PLS. Well, the first three are all file types which can be used in Revit or AutoCAD. or maybe even other design tools. The PLS, though, is a different story. The PLS, which stands for Product Line Sheet, is basically an Excel file, but data in the sheet can be used as a source, for example, in apps. And apps is a total different new thing. We'll go on that later. This just gives you an overview of what we do. Now, how exactly does the content creation process look like? This image just gives you an idea. It all starts with the three main stakeholders, which are the customers, manufacturers, or projects. Customers need content for their projects. They want to deliver a high-quality project. In order to do that, to make their calculations, to make their article list, and to make their quality of a certain their project of a certain quality, they request content from manufacturers. But also manufacturers, they want their products to be available for MEP engineers in BIM projects. And then we also have projects. Often there are quite some requirements for projects in terms of quality, in terms of products, in terms of brands. So a certain project can require engineers to request content from us. And this is where a request goes into our factory. We have a team who will prepare the work, but also teams who will create content, thoroughly test it, review it, and at the end can be published on our platform. Charles, how does the request part work?
Yeah, you give a small overview about the content factory. And in this content factory, the content is being created by this content team. And the content team is definitely not working alone. What they will do, they will take the manufacturer by his hand and lead him through the complete process of request until publication of the content. The content can be placed in different ways. We can create content in different ways, I need to say. You already explained that we can do Revit families, we can do AutoCAD DWG files, we can do the IFC files, and of course we have the PLS file. Just to go a little bit in depth of the PLS file, is not only a file for the Stabicot users, but it's a main source for every kind of content we are creating. The PLS file is actually a file completely filled up with parametric information about the geometric model. If you see on top of this sheet where we have the creation PLS and then an arrow pointing out to some kind of content, you will see that this content is being created by using the information directly from a PLS file. It's lightweight, it's fast, it's easy to use, but it is definitely a very good product to use. It's a real representation of the product with the connectors on the right side, with the information attached to it, with all the information you as an engineer would like to have. But the manufacturer actually wants to have more high quality content. Sometimes they ask for a photorealistic representation of their products. Well, that's nice to have, but that's definitely not something an engineer is asking for, because it will make the project extremely heavy. And that's something we would like to prevent. So, if we're working on a functional design, and we go into that later on, I will explain how the content is actually made. If we go to the data to content process, you already explained here that we can do several kinds of content. Well, let's make a jump from the PIM system into the PLS, for example. We called it option A, from PLS to object. Well, as you can see here on the left top, it will represent just a small overview of the PLS. It will tell us where we can find the connection type or what kind of connection type there is. So you want to make sure that if you want to make a connection between a male and a female connector, it's really working. Or if you're working with flanges, what kind of flanges you would like to attach. That's something what we say on connection type. Diameter, of course, length of products, height of products, width of products, every kind of dimension is being mentioned in the PLS file. The PLS file is feeding a standard family, and this standard family is being created by our content team. And actually, there you can find the link between dimensions on the PLS, dimensions on the scheme, and it will actually create an object. And as you can see in the middle of this screen, there's an object. It's a pump, and maybe you can recognize it on the color. I don't mention the manufacturer, but you will definitely know what kind of pump it is. And it's been automatically generated, and it's been generated as a Revit family. It can be generated as an IFC file or a DWG. And last but not least, of course, it has been a uniform object library, and it will be meet the EMCS standard. If we choose for option B and we're coming on the functional design from a manufacturer, well, we see that we need to have technical data. Technical data in any kind of form, of course, we would like to have it on an electronic way, but most of the time we get a PDF or a text file that's been explaining how the component has been built up, where we can find measurements, where we can find dimensions, where we can find all the information needed to build a component for Revit. Then, of course, we need dimension sketches that could be directly from your R&D department. It could be a step file, could be a SOT file, any kind of 3D geometric file that we can use to recreate the Revit family. This functional design has been taken one by one with you as a manufacturer and with our content factory. And finally, we will reproduce an object, as you can see in the middle. It's more highly detailed. There's more information available, graphic information available. The technical data information is exactly the same if we have that from a PLS file, for example. And now we can also create a Revit family or an IFC or a DWG file on request if you like. And of course, also this content will meet the EMCS to make sure that you get a uniform object library in your project, so you can actually know if you make a schedule what you have in your project available, and of course all the information as GTIN code, for example, so you can order it as well. That's a little bit about depth in how we create content, Jaap, but maybe you have some more info.
Yeah, you already mentioned it, Charles. At the end, it's also about your content should be able to be used for ordering, or maybe you'd like to see some extra information in terms of technical manuals or whatever. And this is why we equip all of our content with manufacturer-specific trade and product data. So besides all the technical parameters, we also make sure that we add deep link URLs to the manufacturer website or GTIN numbers, or maybe even connected with wholesaler databases. So MEP engineers can, right from within their product, order their product at their preferred supplier, or maybe look up more details. So for example, here we see a Kallio S-POM from KSB. And as you can see on the picture on the right, this is a technical data sheet picked from the website, linked from on map content. It just shows you how we can link from web content to manufacturer data. And this is where what is the real added value of BIM, because the information is simply there right in your project. Now, here again, map content. And this is where all of our content is actually published on. But I can imagine that as an engineer, when you're working in your project, you don't want to lose any time on going into your browser, typing in URLs, looking for the right project, looking for the right article. So it might be really handy to access map content right from within your AutoCAD Revit project. And this is why we published the map content browser. The map content browser is here for engineers who want to browse the library from right within Revit or AutoCAD. You can download it from our website, and it will make your life a lot easier.
Okay, you told me that there is an app available. That's the Map Content Browser. It's an app that we are providing to you as an engineer. You can download it for free. It's available for AutoCAD and it is available for Revit. And what it actually does is it helps you to find your content quite easy on the Map Content website. And it's just an app, and that will install directly into your software. Of course, you can use any kind of browser, Jaap, on the Map Content website. Can I use, for example, Internet Explorer?
Anything you like.
Anything I like. Okay, great. And with the Map Content browser, it makes my life much easier. If I talk about make it easier for myself and make it easier for me as an engineer, we forward as Map Content, how can we do it much easier to you? So we provide more apps. And that's something you can find in our Map content store. We do have now several apps available. We have a special one from Sana. It's a piping app. We call it the PLIP, Product Line Placer. And this app will help you to engineer and make a real nice drawing of your Sana piping system with all components attached to it. And maybe there are some special parts that not being available in this app. You can download them directly from the Map Content website. There's another one, one special for electronics. We see there from ABB, the switch range configurator. It's an app that will help you as an electro engineer to place sockets, switches, and so on, and make combinations of components directly placed into Revit. This one is only available for Revit, of course. There will be coming more apps on in the next coming months. Please keep follow this this site and keep follow the store, because you will find that there will more apps being available in the next coming months. But we already told you, we have content, we have apps, and what do you need to do? Well, it's important to get to the Map Content website, and well, Jaap already mentioned it, if you don't have an account, make one, it's for free. We don't invoice you, you are just free to download anything you like. You can download an app, you can use an app, you can just find out if it's the right way to work for you. And if so, well, that's nice, then you have a new tool on your desktop that will help you to create nice projects with realistic data attached to it. It's enriched, it's nice to have, and it will definitely help you as an engineer to make the products quite good in your project. For a manufacturer, of course, you have more exposure from your projects. You can your products being attached to the Map Content website and attached to your own website. So we do some commercial things on that as well. It will help you to expose more of your content out to in the world. And then you can say, yes, I'm BIM ready, and you can find me on Map Content. So if you're not been there, please try to. You can have a free account anytime you like. You can sign in. That's what we would like to say today about Map Content, the Map Content apps, and the creation of content. And we are sure that that will give some questions, or it will give you an idea about, hey, how can I be as a manufacturer available Map Content? Please don't hesitate to call us or email us, and make sure that you keep in contact with our sales team. We are happy to serve you. And not only as a manufacturer, but also you as an engineer. If you have any problems, please let us know. We are glad to serve you. This was just a webinar about content and map content, and why and how we are creating map content and what is offered. Our next webinars, you can see here a small calendar that will tell you that our next webinar will be on the 21st of September. It's about the apps, and well, all other ones are being mentioned here. So if you're not already signed up, go to our website, sign in for this webinar, and we hope to see you next time again. Jaap, are there any questions?
Not so far, but well, if you have any questions, please do feel free to ask them now. This is our question and answer part of the webinar. So if you have any questions, feel free to ask them.
Okay, maybe I can just raise my hand and ask a question, Jaap.
Yes.
Does it make any difference what kind of Revit version I'm using?
It does make. Of course, we try to make our content available to as many versions as possible. But we cannot support all Revit versions, of course, because, well, our content develops with Revit. We support the last three versions of Revit, so that will be Revit 15, 16, and 17.
I guess you mean 18, 17, and 16, because we are now working already with version 19. But okay.
Time flies.
So there is for several Revit versions.
Yeah, the last three versions.
The last three versions, yeah. Suppose I want to have a component that's not on map content. What should I do?
Well, we're very happy to create products that which you need in your project. So in case you need any content, then you can always request it on our website. There's a special request content section on our website, and you can fill in a form here, and well, our content team tries to get back to you.
Okay, and that's the same for a manufacturer, I guess. If I'm a manufacturer and not already represented on Map Content,
of course, please do contact us, and our sales team is happy to help you.
Okay, there is on the Map Content website a special button where you can put in your message, and it will send directly to the right department. Yeah. Okay, I think that we are on the end of our time now for the webinar.
Yeah, just. We'll stay here for a bit longer, but so if you have any questions, feel free to type them in. Otherwise, we'd like to thank you for your time. Hope you've learned something, enjoyed the webinar.
And if you have any questions afterwards, please don't hesitate to call or email us. We are here to help you and to serve you. Thank you very much, and have a nice day.
Have a nice day. Bye.